Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to more WWE 2K16 Universe Mode. My name is BrendenPlayz. We are 1 week away from the Night of Champions pay-per-view. Well, less than a week now, aren't we? We're here with this week's main event and SmackDown. Night of Champions. It will be live June 11th on BrendenPlayz. We are very, very close to getting to that pay-per-view. But first, main event this week, we have Bo Dallas and Heath Slater. The Social Outcasts are calling themselves. They'll be teaming up against the Dudley Boys. Cesaro goes one-on-one with Rhino as he prepares for his big Night of Champions triple threat match, one of many triple threat matches we're having. Speaking of preparing themselves, Kalisto is in action as well against Fandango one-on-one as he tries to prepare for Neville and Night of Champions and the Usos. They'll be taking on the number one contenders for the World Tag Titles, The Miz and Tyler Breeze, the A-listers. Well, there you go, the Social Outcasts, a bit of an upset win over the Dudley Boys. Rhino gets the win over Cesaro as well, so not what he was looking for. Fandango defeats Kalisto as well, so our contenders, and oh, the Usos as well! Our contenders are falling down, doing terrible right now. Alright, so SmackDown this week now. I mean, look, can our contenders do a little bit better? Let's hope so. Jack Swagger looks to continue his very, very impressive run in the last few weeks with a match and a possible victory over Sheamus here tonight. The Miz goes one-on-one with Luke Harper. The Miz and Tyler Breeze, the A-listers, meet the Wyatt family for the World Tag Team titles at Night of Champions. Paige will defend her Divas Championship, and soon to be the Women's Championship, against Nikki Bella at Night of Champions, but she'll take on Brie Bella tonight. The New Day are in action against Golden Truth. Sin Cara, Kalisto's tag team partner, takes on Neville one-on-one. That'll be one of our featured matchups here tonight. And our other one will be the Eater of Worlds. It is Bray Wyatt in action against the number one contender for the world heavyweight title, Triple H. His resurgence back to the top of his game has been impressive. Can he cap it off here tonight and give himself the best preparation possible for Kevin Owens at Night of Champions? We'll find out. Jack Swagger's done it again, a win over Sheamus this time. Swagger, he's in red hot form right now, isn't he? Really trying to stake his claim for a potential title shot down the line. Luke Harper makes it a pretty woeful week for the A-listers. They are not coming into the pay-per-view at all with any momentum, which is not what they wanted. Brie Bella gets a win over Paige as well, so Nikki Bella will have a little bit of one up there on Paige. Tag team action, it is Golden Truth. There you go, a bit of a week of upsets, isn't it? Certainly thought the New Day would get that one done, but the Golden Truth still trying to find their home with a win. So here we go, another matchup to kick this one off here tonight, and it will be Sin Cara and Kalisto. The Lucha Dragons coming out here tonight. Just Sin Cara in action. Kalisto will be watching on the sidelines, the number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship, looking to win the title from Neville at Night of Champions. What a match that is going to be. A match of two very similar styles. I think that's going to be very, very interesting to see who does walk away with that win. Kalisto followed by Sin Cara joining the ring right now. Neville will be coming out in a moment's time. We'll talk more about this match in a moment. But certainly, just to finish up what we were talking about a moment ago, certainly a week of upsets. A lot of our contenders falling down and unable to get the wins just before the pay-per-view. Will it be the same thing here for our champion Neville, trying to come into the pay-per-view with a big win? Will he fall to Sin Cara here tonight and unable to beat him? We'll see how he goes. Will Kalisto be able to get a win, even though it's kind of watching on, but a moral victory anyways for him here over Neville. Triple H will take on Bray Wyatt later on here tonight. I guarantee you right now, Triple H does not beat Bray Wyatt tonight. He will not beat Kevin Owens at Night of Champions, so we'll talk more about that one later on. But that's a huge match coming up later on. So Sin Cara versus Neville. I suppose a match of two similar styles again, isn't it? Two high flyers in action right now. Sin Cara as a single star hasn't really impressed at all, let's be honest. He hasn't really gotten the accolades you'd hope he wanted, you would hope he would want. But as a tag team partner, not too bad. Obviously, we've seen him in a few tag teams throughout Universe Mode, including one with Rey Mysterio a couple of years ago as the Luchadors and now the Lucha Dragons. So Sin Cara as a tag team partner, pretty good. Even though there's yet to be tag team gold for the Lucha Dragons, but as a single star yet to really be determined, I would probably say not so great. Which has kind of led to many saying, you know, should Kalisto just kind of go out on his own? He's doing pretty well as a single star, not so good as a tag team. It's kind of the opposite, isn't it? Are these two guys a good fit for one another? if Kalisto wins the IC title coming up at Night of Champions, as a nice hurricane run there by Neville. I suppose you'd have to ask the question, is it time for Kalisto to go his separate ways, or is it time for Sin Cara, if he wants to be the sidekick for Kalisto, just to be that, rather than try and pursue the tag team goal? Because the Lucha Dragons as a tag team has not had any success at all. Despite, I would say, Sin Cara being a good tag team partner for Kalisto to have, things just haven't worked out for them. But Neville, at the moment, in a bit of trouble as he gets slammed down by Sin Cara. Kalisto, though, has done very, very well as a single star, obviously picking up a number of victories, getting himself in good positions to win championships, and he's been winning a number of high-profile matches that we wouldn't expect him to win. Now, all of a sudden, number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship, and has an opportunity right now at Night of Champions to become the next champion, which will be very, very impressive, considering what Neville's been able to do the last couple of months, obviously getting the win over Randy Orton at SummerSlam. Pretty much put Neville on the map, I would say. Neville was okay on Raw, let's be honest, not so great. He tried to be a tag team partner as well. It's a little bit of a similar situation. Neville tried to be a tag team guy, did not work out at all. And I think we knew Neville as a singles was going to work. And it did when he came to SmackDown and trying to focus on his singles career, obviously leading to an Intercontinental Championship victory. So for Kalisto, he's in a very, very similar situation. He has to kind of think about his future right now. And right now, Sin Cara with a flying forearm. There are Neville in the corner, and Neville will take him down off of his feet. So it's a very similar situation, a similar path, a similar journey that both Neville and Kalisto have gone on. Obviously, Neville a little bit further on in his journey compared to Kalisto. So we'll see where Kalisto goes in the future. But that will be a great clash coming up at Night of Champions. No doubt about that. Sin Cara trying to go from behind. Neville will get a couple of elbow strikes there on Sin Cara and make sure that he cannot capitalize. As well as that, we obviously have the tag team titles on the line as well for SmackDown the World Tag Team Championships up for grabs as the A-listers versus the Wyatt family. We've seen the A-listers been a team for only a few weeks now, but have been very, very successful already. They've shown that they can become a very good team in the future. Have they got enough experience thus far, though, to beat the dominant Wyatt family team? I don't know. But the Wyatt family have been flying under the radar, there's no doubt about that. They're kind of just doing their own little thing. Sometimes they're not even in action, I should say. And I think the Wyatt family probably need to be, you know, showing people how dominant they are more often than not. And I think that might be a thing that might just concern them a little bit. The fact that the A-listers all of a sudden think they can win. Even though they had a one-on-one matchup this week, they lost. But the A-listers are confident. The Wyatt family need to obviously show us how good they are and make sure that the teams that they are coming up against are intimidated, are fearing them, are, you know, worried that, you know, they might get a beating of their life. So the fact that the Wyatt family haven't really shown us that over the last few months, maybe the A-listers will get them feel pretty confident. Obviously, The Miz facing the Wyatts at SummerSlam with Damian Sandow. That didn't work out, so we got a good chance there to see the Wyatts in action. And the Wyatts dominated. There's no doubt about that. They were impressive on that night. So there's no doubt the Miz will be a little concerned heading in towards that pay-per-view. But that'll be one of our other big matches coming up at Night of Champions for SmackDown, as well as the IC Championship and the World Heavyweight title. And the Divas and our Women's Championship matchup. Obviously, currently the championship is the Divas title. After Night of Champions, the championship will be rebranded to the Women's Championship. Neville trying to put Sin Cara away right now. Hook of the leg, and he'll kick out of two. The championship will be rebranded to the Women's Championship. And the winner of the Night of Champions match will have that championship. And obviously, we'll continue on the history of the Divas Championship through the new title. So all the title reigns that has happened throughout the series will still count. It will just be counting as a Women's Championship victory rather than a Divas Championship victory and a new title belt, of course. Sin Cara has Neville against the ropes right now. Neville going to be tossed over the rope now. And Sin Cara, what is he thinking about doing now? Sin Cara, is he going to fly? Sin Cara's thinking about it. He's in the right position. Here he comes. Sin Cara through the ropes. Through the ropes and connected there on Neville. And that is what Sin Cara is all about there. Showing his high-flying ability. Very, very impressive from Sin Cara. Now kicking away there on Neville into the legs. Trying to pick Neville up. Neville with a counter. And a snap suplex by Neville onto Sin Cara. And Neville going to get Sin Cara back to his feet. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take a quick break from this matchup. We'll be back right after this as Sin Cara is back in the ring. Night of Champions will be going live on BrendenPlayz on June 11th at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 7 p.m. UK time, 11 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. It'll be taking place on Saturday night, and it'll be available to watch on YouTube and Twitch, both live. And of course, as always, you can go ahead and watch the pay-per-view once the stream is done on YouTube at any time, any place. Saturday afternoon, Sunday morning, Saturday night, wherever you're from, make sure you come along to Night of Champions live on BrendenPlayz. Hope to see you all there. We're back here on SmackDown, and right now Neville has Sin Cara in the middle of the ring working him down. But during the break, it was a little bit of a different story. As you can see, Sin Cara was going pretty well and taking advantage there on Neville. So it's been back and forth between the two during the break. Right now, Sin Cara back to his feet and has Neville down. And in slightly in a bit of trouble. Sin Cara though, oh! Didn't quite get it though. I don't think so. Springing off the ropes. He's going to go for it again now, and this time connects. So Sin Cara missed the first one. You would say maybe just slightly getting Neville the second time. Pinpoint perfection there by Sin Cara. Now Sin Cara, snapmare takedown to Neville. And has the arm, and he's trying to wear down Neville a little bit further. Kalisto hoping that his tag team partner can get the big win here. Kalisto will want to make sure that Neville's not feeling all that confident heading in to the pay-per-view, because Neville's been in great touch. There's no denying that. Kalisto being a little bit hot and cold at times, and consistency is a little bit of an issue right now from behind. Neville has a chance to capitalize here. Is that enough to put Sin Cara away? Rolls him over. Hooks the leg. This could just be it right now for Sin Cara, who will kick out and keep this one alive. Neville may have just thought he had Sin Cara, but not yet though. Sin Cara fighting through. And now Neville has a hold of Sin Cara, picks him up again. Look out, powerbomb. But did not follow through with a cover there. I thought it was a chance to follow it up with a cover and perhaps go for the win. But he might be having some other ideas. This might be why he didn't want to go for the cover. Neville off the top of the rope. Neville, red arrow. Both legs are hooked. Sin Cara in trouble. Neville gets him. What a win for the Intercontinental Champion here tonight on SmackDown. Just days away from the Night of Champions pay-per-view, Neville shows us what he can do in a high flyer, high versus high flyer situation. Neville, he had it tough against Sin Cara. It was a tough back and forth match at times, but at the end of the day, Neville picks up the win with the red arrow. Well, Sin Cara fought hard, there's no doubt about it, but Neville is just on fire right now. He's a very tough superstar to beat. Kalisto will find it out firsthand when these two men meet at Night of Champions for the Intercontinental Championship. Can Neville continue his great run? He's done so good so far. He's a rising star here on SmackDown, has a chance to become a future world champion. There's no doubt about that. Has all the talent in the world. He just has to keep this going. Just has to keep this momentum flowing. And who knows where he will end up. An impressive win over Sin Cara. There's no doubting his ability there. But at Night of Champions, it will be a different story. There's no doubt about that. Kalisto, he's done very, very well. He just hasn't built the consistency where we can see him potentially becoming a champion for a long time. But if he can start to get that going, who knows where he'll end up. Untapped potential is Kalisto. No doubt about that. But Neville with the win there. Huge victory. And this is the match we're talking about right now. Night of Champions, one-on-one, Neville versus Kalisto for the Intercontinental Championship. I believe Sin Cara will be there ringside supporting Kalisto. So will that play a factor? I don't know. We'll find out at Night of Champions live on BrendenPlayz, as you heard earlier on. So now we'll get on to our next matchup. Main event time here on SmackDown tonight. Nick Combs, a former Intercontinental Champion as well. His name is Bray Wyatt, ladies and gentlemen. Two-time Intercontinental Champion Bray Wyatt, who's been looking to move himself up into the main event scene here on SmackDown. A big opportunity here tonight against Triple H as he prepares himself for a big, big match. Does Triple H against Kevin Owens at Night of Champions, where he will meet Kevin Owens for the World Heavyweight Championship. Tonight, Bray Wyatt will be a very, very tough opponent for Triple H, no doubting that. Bray Wyatt, very, very successful over the past couple years here on SmackDown. And Bray would love a victory here against Triple H to skyrocket him into potential talks about him to be the next world champion. We'll see how he fares later on, but his opponent tonight is the game Triple H. And how good has Triple H been since coming to SmackDown? A career resurgence has been the name of the game, no pun intended. But Triple H has done everything in his power to get himself prepared mentally and physically for Kevin Owens at Night of Champions. Big, big victories, including one last week against John Cena in a hard-fought match back and forth. Triple H managed to hang on and get the win there. A big triple, a fake fatal four-way match, I should say, victory, including a win over Bray Wyatt in that one. Triple H has looked the goods. He has looked the goods and continues to impress. He just has to keep this going. That's been Triple H's problem throughout Universe Mode. He's done well at times, but when the big matches come around, he has not really proved all that well. He's had title matches in the past against the likes of Randy Orton, The Rock, Seth Rollins, and has lost every single one of them. Will things change against Kevin Owens at Night of Champions? We'll find out on Saturday, but right now, Triple H and Bray Wyatt locking up into the corner. They go. Triple H has the advantage here on Bray. But for Kevin Owens, let's be honest, being champion since WrestleMania hasn't even looked like losing the title. Such a dominant champion. I mean, everyone that comes up against Kevin Owens feels as though they're ready, feels as though they're confident and they can beat the man. But Kevin Owens just lifts into a completely different gear, a new level that we've never seen before. Arguably from anyone here in Universe Mode, just this ability to sustain so much damage and survive for such a long period of time. You can hit your best shot time and time again, but sometimes your best shot just simply is not good enough to beat Kevin Owens. You know, he's lost a couple matches here and there, but when it comes to the big one, the big important matches on pay-per-view, Kevin Owens undefeated. He has just been so unbelievable. So, so dominant. And I mean, I guess you could only really compare it to the likes of Brock Lesnar back when he was WWE Champion a couple years ago. I mean, that's really all you can compare it to. But even then, Brock Lesnar was only really appearing on pay-per-views. Kevin Owens is doing this week in, week out, which is why Kevin Owens is so, so impressive right now. Triple H, though, has a hold of Bray and face first he goes. So, I think for Kevin Owens, I think Triple H will just be another guy, just another superstar looking to take the title. You know, for Kevin Owens, Brock Lesnar, Randy Orton, Dean Ambrose, John Cena, Alberto Del Rio. I mean, those are just some of the names that he's beaten. I mean, what else can you really say? CM Punk, a couple times as well. Kevin Owens has just been so, so dominant here on SmackDown. And it's hard to say who will be the man to beat Kevin Owens. Maybe Daniel Bryan's Money in the Bank cash in. Maybe we'll see him cash in at Night of Champions. Maybe that will be the time. We just don't know. But right now, Bray Wyatt in a bit of trouble here against Triple H, but takes Triple H back off of his feet. Nicely done. Obviously, go back to last year's Night of Champions, we had Chris Jericho cash in on the World Heavyweight Champion at the time. It was The Undertaker. So Night of Champions has been the home of cash-ins before here in Universe Mode. Maybe we'll see it happen again this time around with Daniel Bryan. We've already seen Finn Balor obviously cash in his Money in the Bank. Only one Money in the Bank briefcase to go. And Daniel Bryan could be the man to just do that. We'll find out though. Bray Wyatt now has a hold of Triple H. Looking pretty good so far. Bray Wyatt against the number one contender. Triple H scouting him out nicely there with the elbow. There's been a lot of talk obviously. Is Triple H still good enough to be here week in, week out on SmackDown competing for the world title and potentially being a world champion? Obviously, the age talk has been certainly coming up here. Is Triple H past his prime as he kicks out a two there against Bray? Kevin Owens has brought that up. Kevin Owens basically feels as though Triple H, you know, is 10 years past it. He thought this isn't 2002 anymore. This is, you know, the current era. And I think Triple H wants to believe deep down inside that he is good enough to be in this era as a champion. I think in his mind, he thinks he can do it, but his body may say otherwise. And with someone like Kevin Owens being so, just the ability to be so resilient and just never give up and just continue to fight and fight and fight, has Triple H got enough fight in himself to be able to overcome that and sustain a high level of ability for such a long period of time? That's the big question, and that's where Triple H will have to try and prove us wrong. Has he got the ability to be in a high-profile match competing against someone like Kevin Owens for 20-plus minutes and still find a way to dig deep and get a victory? You know, I don't know. Triple H obviously is in great shape, there's no doubt about that, but you have to wonder, is the age of Triple H getting him up there and causing issues? Nothing wrong about that spine buster though by Triple H, and now setting Bray Wyatt up potentially here for a pedigree. Bray Wyatt, no countering the pedigree. Lucky enough there, because he would have been in deep trouble there, Bray Wyatt. That could have been an end to this matchup already. Tossing down Triple H though. So Triple H has fared pretty well here against Bray. But you'd have to say, for Triple H, if he's going to beat Kevin Owens, he's going to have to do it very, very quickly. The longer the match goes, the longer it will favor Kevin Owens. No doubt about that. Face first goes down Bray. Triple H will follow it up with a big kick to the back there. And a stomp there to the arm of Bray Wyatt. Triple H testing himself here against Bray Wyatt right now. Big right hand. This time it's by Bray. And now, Bray Wyatt picks up Triple H and will slam him down right onto the knee into the gut. There, Triple H. Bray Wyatt feels as though that might be enough to put him away here and win this matchup. Triple H has other ideas as he'll kick out at the count of two. Uppercut there by Bray. Connecting really nicely there on Triple H. And the game is in the corner now. Bray Wyatt slowly coming towards Triple H. Kevin Owens, he'll want Triple H to be in this match for as long as he possibly can. Try and wear down Triple H, trying to tire him out before Night of Champions even comes around. Triple H off the top and connects with the elbow. We don't see Triple H head off the top too much. And when he does, it's not really anything flashy or pretty, but it is effective. The elbow there, and that might be something Triple H will have to try and do at Night of Champions. Perhaps be a little bit more innovative to try and take down Kevin Owens. The game. It's a big stomp to the abdomen region. Obviously, Triple H has been around for years and years and years, so you kind of know what he's got to bring to the table, really. So Triple H might have to try and bring out something you don't expect. But hey, when you hit spine busters like that, you can do it all night long, and it will still be as effective as it was years and years ago. I would say there, Bray Wyatt, a little bit unlucky not to get the rope break. He kicked out at two, obviously, but his head was surely underneath the ropes. The referee didn't catch that one. Surely Bray Wyatt should have got the rope break there. A little unlucky, but it didn't matter in the end, thank God. The elbow there by Bray, and now... Oh, wait a second! Bray Wyatt, out of nowhere! Bray Wyatt's got Triple H! Sister Abigail! Well, the game has been dominating for such a long period of time. Spinebusters and spinebusters, but Bray Wyatt delivers the Sister Abigail and can't quite get the win, though, as Triple H gets the shoulder up. Wow. Triple H... That's a test for you right there. And he was able to kick out. Obviously, the setup, the build-up wasn't the best for Bray. Obviously, just receiving a spinebuster. But perhaps it's enough to turn the tables a little bit. Perhaps Bray knew that he might not get the win from it, but it might just turn this match around. Here comes Bray Wyatt. No. The shoulder. Sorry, the elbow up there connects there on Bray. Uh-oh. Triple H getting fire back with his best shot. The pedigree. The pedigree, and that should be it on Bray Wyatt. No! Shoulder up. Perhaps Triple H didn't quite wear down Bray Wyatt enough. And the pedigree, he thought for sure that would be enough. And he can't believe it. But Bray Wyatt, good enough to kick out. And that's why Bray Wyatt is an upcoming superstar, megastar perhaps, here on SmackDown. All the potential in the world. He's very resilient. That's why he's a two-time Intercontinental Champion here in Universe Mode. He is as good as a cut as we've seen here. As good as you'll get here on SmackDown. Triple H takes down Bray. Feels as though that could be enough again here. Just applying a little bit more pressure here on Bray. He'll kick out again. But Triple H closing in on a victory perhaps, but Bray Wyatt not giving up anytime soon. Bray's actually back to his feet first, and that's going to cost Triple H. Bray Wyatt connecting. Well, Triple H, oh no, here comes Bray, launches himself onto Triple H there, and now Bray may have Triple H right here. Hooks the left leg, and Triple H at a count of 2.5, kicking out. Bray Wyatt, that one small thing, it is the little things sometimes, those one percenters that can turn things around, getting to your feet just a half, just a second before Triple H allowed him to hit back and nearly take the match. Triple H making a small error and something he can't afford to do at Night of Champions. And he just swung the arm back, lined Bray Wyatt up and connected right on the button. And Bray Wyatt's down, dropping the knee as well, does Triple H. The Cerebral Assassin coming out to play right now. The game has Bray Wyatt up and down with the backbreaker. And that's what Triple H is all about right now, grinding his opponent down, trying to earn this victory, and Bray will kick out. Putting up a good fight is Bray Wyatt right now. Triple H, is that a sign of frustration or just a sign of fatigue perhaps? Bray Wyatt, snapmare. And Bray Wyatt will slow the pace of this one down, which will certainly suit him. The methodical style that Bray Wyatt has. Trying to slow things down and slowly pick apart his opponent. That's what Bray Wyatt will be trying to do right now. Is he going to be able to do it? I don't know. Triple H firing back. And now the game has Bray in the corner. Triple H is coming. He's taking his time. I'm not sure if he's going to make it in time. He will. Triple H is going to have Bray Wyatt, picks him up to the top of the rope. What is Triple H thinking about now? We talked about it a moment ago. He's not so great up the top of the rope. Bray Wyatt, not the best either, but there's nothing wrong with that. A crossbody off the top. And Bray Wyatt, all of a sudden, back in control. This is the test for Triple H that he needed. He's been looking for. He had it last week. He's having it again here tonight. But so far, he's up to the task. Lines him up again for another clothesline. Bray Wyatt is down. Triple H reassessing. How can he win this match? What does he need to do? Right hand into the back of Bray Wyatt's head. And now Triple H is going to line him up again. Is he going to look for this pedigree once again? Triple H is going to go for it. Triple H hooks both arms. Triple H, pedigree! Pedigree! To Bray Wyatt, and Bray Wyatt is not going to be able to kick out that time. Triple H picks up a much needed victory. Impressive, yes. Hard fought, yes. Is he ready for Kevin Owens? I just don't know. A good win, no doubt about that. The momentum he certainly has. Very, very impressive in the last month of Triple H. Can he beat Kevin Owens? That is an answer I just don't have. We'll find out at Night of Champions this Saturday. But there's no doubting Triple H right now. He is looking good. But Kevin Owens is in a different league. Can Triple H once again get back to his very, very best that we haven't seen for such a long period of time? Certainly, perhaps even ever here on Universe Mode. Triple H, he's ready to play the game at Night of Champions against the man who will just not stop fighting. Kevin Owens versus Triple H for the World Heavyweight Championship. What a match that is going to be. What a Night of Champions card we have. Every single title up for grabs. And we'll even have a pre-show as well. It won't be a Universe Mode pre-show, but we'll be doing our Royal Rumble giveaway that we've been doing on the channel as well. So make sure you are there a little bit early to see the Royal Rumble giveaway and followed up by the Night of Champions pay-per-view. Triple H celebrates his win here tonight, and with good reason. Very, very impressive victory here tonight. And that's Kevin Owens! Kevin Owens is in the ring! Kevin Owens is here, and he attacks Triple H. Triple H celebrating his win. He turned around, he saw Kevin Owens. Before he could do anything about it, Kevin Owens has struck, and now Owens picks up Triple H and slams him down. the package pile driver by Kevin Owens. Well, it's all been about Triple H over the last few weeks. What about Kevin Owens? Just reminding us what he's all about. And Owens now has Triple H against the ropes. Here it comes. Pop-up powerbomb. Owens sending a friendly reminder to Triple H who is the world champion right now and who is the favorite to win at Night of Champions against Triple H and Kevin Owens. Well, Triple H with a win here tonight, but perhaps Kevin Owens has the final say heading into the pay-per-view. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us again here tonight for our episode of Universe Mode. That's the match that we'll be seeing at Night of Champions, plus many more. Hope to see you guys at the live stream. If not, hope to see you catching it on BrendenPlayz after the stream is over. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please do leave a like on this video. It'd be great if we can hit. Let's try go for a big goal. Let's go for 20 likes this episode. If you haven't already, make sure you do subscribe to see Night of Champions when it does come on BrendenPlayz. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you all in the next video.